Google, your day-to-day search engine. You can literally search anything on here and you'll get results within the blink of an eye. For example, hey Google, what's the weather in London, England right now?
Right now in London, United Kingdom, it's 9 degrees and partly cloudy. Today, it will be mostly cloudy with a forecast high of 19 and a low of 8.
See, my Google Home Mini just told me the weather in London, England. You can do more than just a weather search on Google. Well, what more can you do? That's what I'm about to show you in this video. Welcome to the first series of Advanced Google Searching. In this video, I'm gonna be talking about Google Dorks. What are Google Dorks? Well, they're just advanced Google searches that allow you to find literally anything on Google. For example, leaked passwords, leaked hashes, leaked camera footage, leaked databases, and much, much more. So now, if you want to learn how to do this, be sure to stick around. And before we get over to the computer, my name is Syed Tarab, and I provide you with great educational content on crypto, blockchain, cybersecurity, and much, much more. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future videos. And if you find this video educational, be sure to hit the like button as well. Now, let's head over to the computer. All right, so in this first dork, let's look for files on Google. So we're gonna start off the dork by first putting in title. This basically narrows the search. And then we're gonna do index of. This specifies what we're gonna search for. And then after that, we're gonna do in URL. And here, since we wanna do file, we're gonna do FTP, which is file transfer protocol. And just to narrow the results of our search based on time, we're gonna do after 2021. So it shows us about like a year and a half-ish, around 14 months of results. And let's search this. And as you can see, there's a bunch of FTP servers right here that we have found using this search. And now let's click on one of these to show you all what potentially we can find. This is an Ubuntu FTP server from what it looks like. See Apache. Let's see what's in here. There's a project in here. Fine, so let's look at another one. Ooh, now we have directories. Now we're dealing with directories here. Let's check out the parent directory. So this leads us to a university page. A university has their FTP server wide open to the public. This is a PHP page that provides us a manual of some sort. Let's click on this. It looks like another education site. And as you can see, there's a bunch of books here, a bunch of PHP, PHP stuff, all class material and all that. So let's go back. A radio again, it's an FTP server, and there's a bunch of directories, aka folders here, and here you can check out which ones they are. But this just goes to show you what you can find when you just use this dork and you search for FTP. This one looks pretty cool. Index FTP private, a list of the server's top level, and of course URL not found. All right, so for the next one, we'll look for passwords. This is gonna get more juicy as the video goes along, so make sure you stick around to the end. We're gonna go all in text, and again, these are commonly used queries that people actually use, so that's why it's appearing right here, right? Because I'm an incognito. This is not my search history. This is just common searches that people use, so people do this all the time. But for our purposes, we're gonna do all in text, and we're gonna just do password, and this is gonna narrow down the search to password. And it's gonna search for password in the text. Now, the file type we're gonna look for is logs, because logs are where passwords are usually stored. Now, I expect to see hashes here rather than passwords. If you don't know what a hash is, I'll be talking about those in the future. But essentially what it is it's a one-way encryption mechanism where your password or anything, any like, say for example, a file or an image is secure, and like it's a unique string and it can't be reversed back to the image. You can't backtrack, basically. So that's what a hash is at a high level. It looks like we don't have that many great matches. Let's try to alter this.
There we go. So after 2021, we really don't. But let's see. Here we see some database passwords of a Postgres SQL database. Here we see PuTTY. And again, this is just a database a log. And here, if we just do a control F, we look for password equals, and the password is blank. So I guess it's not nothing to really worry about here.
Let's take a look at logs.login for your accounts, logins, and passwords.
Login high, password polo. Look at this. Someone's Proton mail. This is leaked right here. Now, I don't know how accurate these are. Again, this is for educational purposes only. I by no means am promoting for you to go and log into these accounts or try them yourselves. This is for information gathering and educational purposes, just so you don't make weak passwords and you don't have your passwords publicly available so they can be tracked down. The goal of these videos is for you to stay secure, and that's why I'm showing you all this. Please don't log into any of these because that's not ethical, right? And that goes against the ethics of InfoSec and cybersecurity. We're gonna look at databases. So now we have file type. We're gonna specify an environment, which is env, and then we're gonna put in quotation marks db password. This is essentially gonna give us any file that has the environment variable, and in the environment variable there's going to be db password. So that's what this is going to give us, and again we'll just put like after 2021. I know in the previous search it didn't really give us any results, but let's see here. We get only two results, and there's this GitHub, so I think we'll put this to after 2020, and here we get more results. So this really isn't the best one out there, but it's one of the ways where you can potentially find database passwords right here. So if we took out the after here, as you can see, db username is this, password's this for this server. Note that it's HTTP, it's not secure, so I'm not going to click on it. There's a GitHub right here for Django, looks like. Database name is this, password's this. Now, this does not look like a hash to me. I was expecting hashes, but it looks like they have plain text passwords for these databases right here, for these servers. As you can see, all these servers, they have username and then password in plain text right here. The passwords are in plain text. And you never want to do that. So if you have any type of database server, make sure your database password isn't leaked like this online in public. And again, that's the purpose of these videos, right? Because this is really crazy stuff, how the password of these databases is available online, and you just gotta run this simple
Google and Drive. I saved the best for last, and this one is gonna for beginners, that is, gonna shock some of you, because in this one it's gonna show us live webcam footage. So we're gonna do in URL top.htm. Top.htm is basically gonna show us cameras. And then in URL, we're gonna do current time, because we wanna see current footage. So let's see what it gives us. As you can see, there's a camera footage right here. Now, I will make a follow-up video for just specifically cameras, leveraging Shodan. As you can see, there's a camera right here. Back to Shodan. Yes, so I will talk about Shodan in the future video, so stay tuned for that. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see an in-depth review of Shodan. If you don't know what Shodan is, basically, it's full of IoT devices, open ports, IoT devices that have open ports. They're gonna be on Shodan, basically, kind of like this webcam. So Shodan is a tool that I plan to cover on my channel, so stay tuned for that. But this is just an intro or a teaser to Shodan using Google. As you can see, there's another webcam right here. Please note though, if you are doing this OSIN searching, have like an isolated environment, a virtual machine, where you can click on these links, because you don't want to catch a virus in your main computer, right? If you want to learn how to set up a virtual machine using VirtualBox or VMware or even Parallels, drop a comment down below. I'll be more than happy to walk you through how to set up a virtual machine. But I'm currently using a virtual machine, so I don't have to worry about that, but make sure you do as well. I'll also be talking about VPNs and all that in the future, so stay tuned. But this basically gives you live camera footage. I could go on and on, but I guess we could just take out an URL and show you all what shows up. See, this is an example of a bad Google dork, because it's just showing us what top.htm is. All of the dorks that I showed you previously, I kind of came up with myself by just learning how Google dorking and advanced query searching works. But if you want like more advanced working dorks that you can literally copy and paste, you can go over to this website called exploitdb.com/Google Hacking Database. Just click on this icon in the home page, and here you can see a bunch of dorks by several authors right here, and it has categories too. It's just a matter of copy and pasting. Say for example, you want to find files containing juicy information, pages containing login portals, and stuff like that. You can pretty much come here and pretty much copy and paste this. I do plan to in the future perhaps contribute to this as I continue to learn and teach you all too, but so far I consider myself a beginner. So while being a beginner, I'm going to continue to learn and teach you all. But this database can be leveraged if you're actually doing OSINT or open source intelligence gathering, and basically it's just a matter of copy and paste. So if, for example, you want to look at pages containing login portals, we go here, we literally just copy this Google search, or you can just click on it. I will click on this, open it in. This is basically looking for a login.php portal, a login page, and all these results come up. It gives all of these admin logins right here. Basically what they're trying to do is they're trying to get to a web page's admin portal, and then there they would try to work around that and try to get the password of the admin page, see if the web page is vulnerable to any type of like cross-site scripting or any type of like, you know, any type of web attack, and then go from there. So
well, that brings us to the end of the video. Now you see how powerful Google can be if you want to gather information. All it takes is a little querying and using Google Dorks, and you can find whatever you want to find. With that being said, this video was for educational purposes only, and anything you find out of Google is publicly available, right? And since it's publicly available, it's known as open source intelligence, aka OSINT. I'll be covering more methods of OSINT in future videos, so stay tuned for that. And if you found this Google Dorks video interesting and you want to learn more about dorking, be sure to subscribe to the channel and like this video. It'll help me a lot, and it'll help like-minded people come across this video so they can learn about Google as well and how powerful it is. With that being said, my name is Sad Tarab, and until next time.